Hi Scorpio, it's Sloane Rhodes here with your love and romance reading for the month of September 2017. This is for Scorpio Sun, Moon, and Rising. I'm losing my voice. Scorpio, so this is an adjunct video, a supplement to the love and romance reading I did previously for all signs, for you in particular, Scorpio, Sun, Moon, and Rising, for the month of July, August, and September. It's just a fun video for the month of September to give you additional tools for the month of September and love and romance. So, Scorpio, I'm going to be drawing one card from the Romance Angels as the overarching theme for the month of September for you. And then I'm going to be drawing three cards from the Sensual Wicca Tarot, with the positions being what you are meant to do or start doing, what you're meant to not do or stop doing, and what is the kind of expected, what is likely to happen regardless in this situation as we move forward. So let's just go ahead and get the cards drawn, Scorpio, and it will make sense as we go along here. This is for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Again, I strongly encourage you to watch or listen to the other video that I did, because this is a supplement to it. That the other video I did is more comprehensive. And Scorpio, don't forget, I also have the Life, Purpose, and Career readings up for July, August, and September as well, as well as the weekly spiritual guidance videos for all astrological signs. Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, September 2017. Okay, here we go. Worth waiting for. Divine timing is at work in your love life. One of the other signs got this too. I can't remember who it was. It may have been Aries, but I'm not sure. All right, so worth waiting for. Divine timing is at work in your love life. Well, Scorpio, I know that this card can be frustrating for many people because it does kind of imply that there is a wait, like what you want has not yet materialized. But be patient. Remember that you're not wanting to manifest a relationship where you're only getting partial rewards, right? You're really wanting the wholeness, right? And the more that you've been working on your own wholeness, loving yourself, the more that you are sending out those sort of waves of intention to attract in a partner who resonates with that sense of wholeness that you are experiencing in your own life. So just be patient here, Scorpio. Regardless of whether you are coupled or single, it's still the same message, which is, you know, be patient. Know that what you want is coming to you the more that you hold your sense of intention and desire close to your heart. Not out of fear that you won't get what you want, but out of knowing that you are already whole and complete and that you are wanting that in a partner as well, so that your partner is not looking to you to fill them up and you're not looking to them to provide, to shore you up, but that you're already feeling that sense of wholeness inside already. And it's not easy working. You've been doing a lot of work around this, Scorpio, I know you have. So just continue to be patient here, because it's worth waiting for. What you've been wanting is coming to you, and it'll be worth waiting for. It is worth waiting for. So, in the position of what you are meant to do or start doing, in the position of what you are meant to not do or stop doing, and in the position of what we can expect from the situation regardless, I'm going to be pulling three cards here. Scorpio, Sun, Moon, and Rising. Okay, here we go. The Fool. This is in the area of what you are meant to do or start doing. In the area of what you're meant to not do or stop doing, we have the Acolyte of Cups, which would be the Knight of Cups. And in the position of what's likely to occur regardless, we have the Two of Cups. Oh, Scorpio, what a beautiful card for you. We have the Five of Wands in there, underneath the deck here, but I'll get to that in a second. Let me show you the cards as I see them, Scorpio. So we have the beautiful Full card in the position of what you're meant to do. We have the Acolyte of Cups in the position of what you're meant to not do. And the likely outcome or the likely what we can expect from the situation regardless is we have the Two of Cups. So that's fantastic, and it's going to be worth it. Everything you've been working on is coming to you, Scorpio. Remember that the Two of Cups isn't like like the Sun card or whatever, but it does show that what's likely to occur regardless is more open-hearted communication, more open-hearted sharings and experiences with another person, regardless of whether you're single or a couple, which is really, really lovely for you. So in the position of what you're meant to do or start doing, we do have the Fool card, right, Scorpio? And I think we talked about this, or I talked about this a little bit in the last Love and Romance reading for you for July, August, and September, if I remember correctly. There's this idea of a little bit of jadedness sometimes with Scorpio. You know, you're so aware of other people's emotions, and you're very, very clever at tuning into what people are feeling, that it can lead you unconsciously sometimes to manipulate, not in the pejorative sense, but just bend situations or people to your will. I think that's how I mentioned it in the last video. So just be aware of that, because you're being asked here with the Fool card, with the Fool card in this position of what to do or what to keep doing. It's to be slightly more innocent, right? It's to be open. You don't have to work so hard is kind of the message here in this position. And travel. If you are looking for love, or if you are single and you are debating traveling, it looks like during the month of September there's a lot of support for traveling to meet someone from a different land or a different culture here. Continue to be open in this way. It is going to be worth waiting for. That which you've been seeking is seeking you. So this card encourages a bit of innocence, a bit of a leap of faith here, travel, and the opportunity to meet people from a different culture, a different society kind of thing. So that's really fun. That's really great energy. Fresh is really, it's actually a really lovely spread for you. We have a lot of new beginnings. We have the zero and the two. We have the five of wands under the deck, but that's kind of an aside, you know. But right in the center, which is what you're meant to not do or to stop doing, we have the acolyte of cups, right, the knight of cups. So, Scorpio, don't spread yourself too thin. You know, make sure that you are not giving your heart to everyone, that you are being more discerning. Remember, it's worth waiting for. What you've been wanting has been in motion for a while. And what you're wanting, you're not just wanting insincere connections with others, superficiality. You're wanting something deeper. And that's what you're likely to get regardless. It's coming for you. Again, it could be that you meet someone and have a really pleasant exchange. It could be something a bit more intense than that. But the Two of Cups does indicate a lovely connection with another person, which I love to see for you. But again, with this as being your kind of cautionary tale here, the cautionary note of what you're not meant to do, what you should stop doing is stop giving so freely of your love to others if it's not sincere and if it's not reciprocated. You're wanting to shift a pattern around that here. I don't know what else to say about that. It's pretty clear. All right, so let's talk about the Five of Wands under the deck here. This is an underlying energy. It does indicate there may be some competition. So there may be some competition for you because we do have this, right? So if there are many suitors, so to speak, don't give your emotions to all of them. You know, be selective here. This is what you're being encouraged not to do, right? And also, don't believe everyone who comes to you with an offer of love, you know? Be more discerning than that. And with this Five of Wands in terms of an underlying energy, so again, there may be some competition, there may be a little bit of a battle between your head and your heart. Maybe someone's offering you something, or maybe there's just more competition than usual, and you're like, I just want to play. Well, that's okay, as long as you're being conscious about it. But I think because we have this card as the overarching theme for you, Scorpio, what you're wanting is something a little deeper than that, maybe a lot deeper. And it looks like it's coming for you. Regardless, but remember, before you manifest this, you want to make sure that you are open to it, right? The Fool is not jaded. The Fool is not trying to create situations or manipulate situations in order to get what the Fool wants. The Fool is just kind of open, like, I'm going to go for it. Like, oh, this person's available. This person wants me. I want them. And there's not a lot of thought necessarily into it. It's more honest. It's more real. It's more childlike. Like when a child goes up to another child on the playground, says, want to play? And the other child's like, yeah, let's play. And they don't have anything, any agenda set. They don't have any plan in mind of exactly what they're going to do, how long they're going to do it for. They're just, hey, want to play? Yeah. You know, it's like when you go to the dog park or whatever. Another dog runs up to a dog and, okay, and then off they go. You know, it's that kind of thing. The reason I bring up the dogs is because there's a certain innocence, you know, a certain joie de vivre around dogs that I feel coming in with this card, even though there's a cat represented here on the card. Yeah, so remember, Scorpio, so what we should stop doing, or you're meant to stop doing, or you're meant to not do is, first of all, accept every offer as it comes in. And also, you're really being encouraged here to be sincere and to be more selective in who you give your heart to, based upon the changes that you've already set in motion. So I hope you find that helpful, Scorpio, and enjoyed it. I wish you much love, and I will see you on the next video, or it's your private appointment, or maybe over on the podcast on iTunes and SoundCloud, or on the weekly spiritual guidance video. Till then.